Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Mushakalmi. Hope you all are doing well. Today's tutorial will be a slightly different one because it's back to basics tutorial. So in this tutorial I'll be showing you some basics to crocheting tips and tricks, what kind of hooks or needles you require to create any project and the types of yarns. So this is a beginner friendly tutorial, so if you're interested, let's get started. First thing that you require to do any kind of crocheting is the crocheting needles. So they come in various sizes. So this is 0.5 mm in size and the hook is very tiny. So you can see it's numbered 0.5 mm and the hook is very tiny. This hook is 1.25 mm in size and the hook is slightly bigger than the previous one. And they are in stainless steel finish. The next hook that I own is this gray one in the matte finish and I think it is 2.25 mm in size. This is the one that I mostly use for all my projects. Here comes the 2.5 mm crocheting hook and this is in the metallic finish. So next comes the big sized hooks that is 4.0 mm in size and these are specially used for thick yarns or the woolen yarns. So you see the hook is like very big. And the last one that I own is this 5 mm crocheting hook, also in the matte finish. And you see how big the hook is and how fat the needle is. So these are the needles that I own. So this is how you hold the needle. The flattest part is where you hold the needle for the grip required. So next requirement to do any kind of crochet is the yarn, obviously. I don't need to say that, but I prefer using Elise Diva yarns that are made in Turkey. This is my personal preference. So if you see the sticker, you'll get to know the details of what kind of hook to use. So here it is given 1-3 sized hook and these are 100% microfiber acrylic with silk effect. And whenever you buy any yarn, see how many grams it weighs. So 100 grams and how long it is. So it's 350 meters in size. So all the details of regarding the yarn will be mentioned in the sticker. See, this is the color lot. So these are multicolored yarns. I love using this. These are very thin and I love to work with these kind of yarns because the overall project will not become very heavy. So this is how it will look like. This is how thin it is. Next is this yarn. This is slightly thicker than the previous one. So remember, never mix up your yarns while doing a project. So see how this is slightly thicker than the previous one. This is also from Elise Diva. Next in line is this Elise Angora Gold Simli yarn. This is slightly with a woolen finish and a metallic finish. I don't know why it doesn't show here. So it is 75% acrylic, 10% mohair, 10% wool and 5% sin. And it is metallic in texture. It's 100 grams, 500 meters. I don't know why the metallic finish is not showing through. It's thin yarn, but with a woolen finish. I purchased this from Junoon Crochet. It's an Instagram account in Kuwait. So this, see how thin it is, but it has woolen texture to it with a metallic finish. Next are these yarns. These are woolen finish yarns. They are very thick in size than the previous ones that I showed you. So you see the thickness here. They are very thick woolen yarns. You can do projects, but they tend to become more heavy. So you use 4.0 mm or 5.0 mm crocheting needles to create any kind of project. I'll be showing you some basics to crocheting because the first thing is you should know how to create a slip knot. So whenever you begin any kind of crochet, you need to do a slip knot. So take your yarn like this and form a circle. See, just wrap the yarn over and you form a circle. And bring that running yarn under the circle. So there you go, bring it under so it comes in between the circle. Now with the help of your needle, with the help of the hook of your needle, bring it up like this and pull both the yarns, one is the end one and one is the running yarn, and pull it tight and Adjust it according to the size of your needle. Don't hold it very tight, it should be loose enough to move your needle through. So you see that, and that's what we call a loop. So here is the loop. Now to hold your needle, hold the flat part of your needle like this to get the grip. Now insert your hook through that loop like so. Now the end part, it's very long enough, either you can cut it off or leave it like that, it's okay. So leave your yarn very free so that it moves around. Some people like holding it, wrapping around the finger, but I like holding it this way. It's just personal preference. So when you start doing crocheting, you know how to hold your yarn. So the next will be your foundation chains. So you need to form chains. So to begin with, there are some crocheting terms that I'll use here. So let's begin. Yarn over. That means you just take the needle below your yarn or the yarn above your needle. So this is called yarn over. So take your hook under that thread and pull it using your hook, that small size hook, and pull through. That is pulling the yarn through the previous chain. So there you form a chain. See, do you see that? So again, yarn over, that is take your needle under the yarn, with the help of that hook, pull the thread through. So you need to practice, it's not difficult. Even if I'm explaining in a slow manner, you might think that it's difficult. It's not difficult at all. You just need to practice, that's it. I'll be forming a few more chains here. So the next trick is hold on the flattest part of your needle and move it around. See, to your left and to your right. See, keep tilting it. So yarn over, you tilt your hook, and yarn over and you tilt it again. So keep on, it keeps on moving from left to right. If you're doing any kind of a circular project or a square shape project or anything, the next term that we use is a slip stitch, that is joining these chains to form a circle. So here you already have a loop on your needle, so now you will insert through the first chain that you form. So insert your hook like this, you'll have two loops on your needle like so. Can you see that? Now with the help of that hook, you'll pull that first loop through the second one, and that is called a slip stitch. You see how this circle is formed? I'm not doing any kind of project, this is just to show you the basics to crocheting. So next, so we learned three things. Yes, a slip knot, foundation chains, a slip stitch. Next will be single crochet. So you just insert that hook through the middle, through the center of the circle, and get it to the other side. So insert that hook or the needle and get it to the other side, yarn over. So remember, yarn over. So yarn over and pull through, you'll have two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through both the loops. So this is called a single crochet. Let's do it again. So insert your hook through the middle, yarn over and pull through. You'll have two loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through both the loops. So a single crochet is formed. So again. So the next will be how to create a double crochet. So for double crochet, you yarn over. So you already have one loop here. So yarn over and insert your hook through the middle of this circle like so. Yarn over and pull through. You'll have three loops. So the previous one had two loops, now you have three loops here. So yarn over and pull through the first two loops, like so. You will struggle a bit here, but it's okay. Now you have two more loops again, so yarn over and pull through both the loops. So let's get going again. Yarn over, insert your needle through the circle, yarn over and pull through. You will have three loops in total. Yarn over and pull through two, and yarn over and pull through two. So this is a double crochet. So I'm going again here to create a double crochet. So sometimes when you yarn over and pull through, your needle might get stuck. So don't worry, it does. Even I get stuck at times. So the long tail that is there, sometimes I keep joining it with the double crochet like so. So it's okay, you can cut it out if you don't want. So here I'm creating more double crochets. So sometimes the pattern calls for a chain stitch, so you can do a single chain here like so and create a double crochet. So that creates the gap between two double crochets. So next is this doing any kind of stitches in between the chain space. So you can easily create a single crochet or a double crochet as the pattern requires. But sometimes the pattern requires you to create a single crochet or a double crochet over the previous chain. So see, these are the chains here. So I'll show you how to create single crochets and double crochets over it. So you simply insert your hook under the chain. See, you can see those two threads there. Yes. So you insert your hook there and yarn over and pull through and pull through two, and you create a single crochet. So the same thing with the double crochet. So you insert under that chain. So here is the chain, so you can see it here. Insert your needle through the under that chain, so not through, under the chain. So you can see those two threads there. Yarn over, pull through two, and pull through two, and that creates your double crochet. I'll be creating more of these. So these are the basic stitches that you require to do any kind of beginner friendly patterns. So most of the patterns that I've created on my YouTube channel are beginner friendly, so do check that out and create them and tag me at mushakkalmecrochet. So the basic stitches are the slip knot, the foundation chain, the slip stitch, single crochet and double crochet. And if you ever make a mistake while doing this, you can just remove that hook and pull the thread or the yarn through, so it will open the pattern. So I hope you enjoy watching this tutorial. If you did, please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel Mushakkalme. And also follow me on Facebook and Instagram for more such videos. Until next time, bye.